In this lesson, we will discuss the primary flight controls, which control and balance the aircraft in pitch. Longitudinal control is achieved by the use of elevators, which are flap-type controls normally fitted to the trailing edge of the tailplane or stabilizer. These surfaces control the aircraft in pitch about the lateral axis. The controls must be adequate to balance the aircraft throughout its speed range, at all permitted center of gravity positions and configurations, and to give an adequate rate of pitch for maneuvers. The pilot controls the elevators by the use of a yoke or control column. This control operates the flying control surface and is moved in a fore and aft direction by the pilot to control the aircraft. If the pilot pulls the yoke or control column towards himself, then the elevator moves up. The degree of movement of the cockpit control directly affects the angular displacement of the control surface. This movement produces an aerodynamic downforce on the tail, which will pitch the aircraft nose up. If the pilot pushes the yoke or stick away from himself, then the elevator will move down. An up force will now be produced on the tail, which will pitch the nose of the aircraft down. Varying the incidence, and hence the angle of attack of an aerofoil, will also vary its lift. This system is often used instead of elevators for pitch control. The whole of the tailplane or stabilizer is rotated to vary its angle of attack. If the yoke is pushed forward, the leading edge of the stabilizer moves up, and the trailing edge down. This increases the lift generated by the stabilizer, so the nose of the aircraft pitches down. If the yoke is pulled back, then the stabilizer rotates in the opposite direction, and the nose pitches up. That is the end of the lesson. You should now understand that control in pitch is achieved using elevators or a moving tailplane.